Double gates open. 2008, we heard that. It was a year of new beginnings. Anybody heard that? I know I got a few charismaniacs in here. Anybody hear that 2008 was a year of new beginnings? It was a year of new beginnings. In 2008, our son, my wife, had a son in her womb. And the Lord said every generational curse you had to go through, every tie you had through that bloodline, all the hell you went through your youth, all the addictions you had to break on your own, God sent your son. He's never going to have to go through what you went through. Because 2008 was a year of new beginnings.
Yes.
And new beginnings pursued through 2008. But what often happens, guys, is that we think that the beginning of something should look like the end of something. We think that once we give birth to a baby, that it's supposed to look like that the rest of his life. Or either that, we think when we give birth, it's going to come into its mature stature immediately. There's only one man that was ever created and never saw childhood, and his name was Adam. But there was something called the law of reciprocity that happened after Adam. And Adam put, God put Adam in a deep sleep. And as Adam was asleep, God opened up his side. In 2016, God's going to take some stuff out of him. Guys, is what's fixing to happen in this house, and people that didn't show up, they missed it. In 2016, God's going to take some stuff out of you. 2008, watch this. God began to open up our spiritual side, and he began to take some things out of us. When God put Adam in a deep sleep, he took out his rib. He took out the womb, actually, and womb man. Man and woman was standing side by side. When God opened his eyes, he saw a full-grown woman looking right back at him. And God took Adam into a garden to rule and subdue. And then he puts Adam to sleep. And then he takes the woman out of the man. And then he tells man to go back into the woman to consummate. And once they can, they become one flesh. See, what we don't understand is that when God links up a husband and a wife, God didn't bring her to me to look pretty in a pew. The days of that chauvinistic pink spirit are coming to a close. God's raising up men and women that are going to stand side by side and do the work that God has called them to do. The days of a one-man show, they're coming to a close. By myself, I cannot carry the seed till it comes into maturity. If I want to give birth to something, I gotta take my seed and I gotta put it in her, and then it's gotta find an egg, and it's gotta be fertile, and then it's gotta produce, and then it's gotta form what you want. God is people in churches that are trying to reproduce what people in, and you're trying to reproduce what those are, aren't even after your own kind. And it was the beginning of something, guys. Oftentimes what happens is that you give birth to something, and when you give birth to it, it doesn't look like the promise, because babies are ugly. They look horrible. I've seen two come out. They don't look good. If that's what happens oftentimes, though. We're in labor. We're in sweat. We're in tears. We're in travail, believing God for his finished work. And then when we see it, well, my God, what is this that you just put in my hand? It's covered in blood. It's covered in slime. But there comes a time of reward. I can tell you,
gotten to an age, he's gonna be two in April. And Ethan, he'll come up, he'll do the funniest things. I see a personality developing on the inside of this little man. I see character that's arising that wasn't there. I see good looks coming out. A head full of beautiful hair. I see development. Oh my God, you're not hearing what I'm saying. The end of a thing, it's not the beginning of a thing. And oftentimes, we judge the beginning by what it looks like, not knowing that the end has not arrived. It's just the beginning. It's just the first fruits.
Everybody, I'm shaking. Let me get my baby picture. It's like, aww. Now, some of you women may disagree. It's okay. I'm like, yeah. Oh, that's the cutest. That's the prettiest baby I ever saw. You lie. Now, the truth is that they were born in their infancy to be beautiful. They have to develop. They have to go through stages when God births something out of you. See, God birthed it in 2008, and some of you thought you were born it. Some of you thought you just going to give up on it because it didn't look like what you thought it was going to look like. It wasn't the full growth. It wasn't the full-grown man that you expected. It didn't have the fullness of what God had promised you. You knew that God had told you something. And then when you gave birth to it. Yes. I said, if you want to know what it looks like, look at his parents. If you want to know what it looks like, look at his grandparents. That's why. You're not going to see an apostle of 10 members oversee this ministry. You can't give me what you ain't got, honey. And I sure don't want my baby looking like you. Woo! Me and this woman, we made some good-looking children. I'm telling you, if you hook up in 2016 with the right people, you can find out that when God's going to birth, what God's got for you. Jesus, not the Jesus of the scriptures. I'd rather not. Thank you very much. No, what you got, the moment you give birth to something, you find out you're going to the nations. You find out that God's called you into Jacksonville to start a movement that's not been here before. Somebody's going to come up to you and say, I'm that baby's daddy. They're going to try to take credit for what God birthed in you. They're going to try to take over, and then you're going to find years, and your baby ain't grown. Something's wrong. It's unhealthy.
It's colicky. It cries a lot. It's not growing. It's malnourished. It's got jaundice. And we don't know what's wrong. Some people's babies have Down syndrome, mentally retardation. Why? Because you gave it to be the, you gave a father to oversee it. That's mentally retarded. You gave a father to, it sounds funny, it's the truth. You gave a father that's going to abuse it, that's going to keep it down, that's going to beat it, that's going to know Jesus. I'm telling you, Pharaoh, God says, let my people go. You don't know what this is. This is called prophecy. Just Lisa said, we got a different crowd than we thought we'd have, so we have to hear the Spirit and find Him and speak. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, who's your baby's daddy? I'm going to go ahead and tell you spiritually, watch me, spiritually, everything you conceived has been by the Holy Ghost. If God didn't care about your baby's daddy, then God would not have cared if Joseph would have gotten married, a bill of divorce. Instead, He sends the angel Gabriel, give him a vision in the night, and says, fear not, Joseph, to take Mary as your wife, for this child that she's carrying has been conceived by the Holy Ghost. And so I examined wisdom, and I looked for a thing, and I looked over Jacksonville. And I saw storefront curses rising on every corner, claiming to be somebody's baby's daddy. Wow. Anybody want to look at my notes and see if any of this is in it? You watch. And I could be accused of being a Joseph. To share too much, get thrown into a pit. We done been through the pit. We done been through the fire. We done been locked in chains. We been through the midnight hour. And all we can do is praise God. Yeah. But you watch and see. We're a young church. We just started, guys. Edwin, you know we just started. You watch. We'll be busting out the seams. And you watch how many bishops want to be our baby's daddy. Where were you? Where were you when we were crying? Where were you when I thought I was going to lose my mind? Where were you when I decided tonight, I'm going to a barroom and I'm going to have a shot of Crown because I can't handle it anymore? You act like you've got it all together. You can take your religious self and you know where to put it. I'm looking for some real people. People that's been through something. People that's got a testimony and can say, I've been through it. And I overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the Word. The Word of my testimony. They counted you out. They said you'd never make it. They said you'd never succeed. But God said, unless a corn of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if you go through your midnight hour, honey, yeah, you know, I walk through the valley of the shadow. You're about to break ground. There's a breach. How do you go into living? There's got to be a breach. Somewhere there's got to be a breach in that matrix. Some of you wonder why you haven't given birth yet. God, he said, because I wasn't going to let no man get glory. You want know why you've been hitting me, because I'm not going to let no man get the glory. Joseph couldn't take the glory for Jesus. I don't want to get on my message for Sunday morning. God don't want no man to get the glory for what he's doing in your prophet. Relationship in the kingdom of God is not vertical, it's horizontal. Oversee does not mean to cover. To oversee means there's accountability. Yeah. Who's covering? The Holy Spirit. Oh, brother, you're in a no. I've done been there. I've done been down that road of control. I've done seen that form of pride, that form of arrogance. The young men and women think that they got power. And you can't cast a flea off a dog, not a broken demon out of a man. Yeah. Who's your cover? I got accountability. There's men in my life that's going to speak into my life. And continually, as my wife had mentioned, the relationship God has given us to build with somebody who's been away that we're seeking to pursue. God's raising up men and women in the earth that's going to raise you up. Men and women, let me tell you something about my sons. I want to see them go higher than I've ever been. I'll not suppress my sons. What kind of father says to his son, you stay here and I'm going to watch myself dictate you? We got 40-year-old men still subdued and tied down in churches that have to call God to the nations. Just let it go, let it go. I can't hold it back anymore. Let it go. Let it go. You know what I'm talking about? I've subdued these powers long enough. I had to keep them hidden long enough. I had to stay locked in a room in this castle. I own the kingdom. Chamber, because people don't understand my power. I gotta hide in this chamber. They don't understand my ability. They don't know I have a gift. And I'm afraid if I release my gift, everybody's gonna let it go. Let it go. How do you know you can preach from the Disney movie Frozen? I could definitely give you a parable out of the Lego movie. Another time. But if you ever really want to know what the controlling spirit looks like, and you don't have time for a deep theological study, just watch the Lego movie. Pay attention. Pay attention. Because there's a resistance against you. There's a resistance against your creativity. There's a resistance against your artisticness. There's a resistance against what God wants to do in your life. Because we don't have shepherds that want to see you come into the fullness of who God's called you to be. We want people warmers. We want people that can just be a tithe on Sunday morning. Show up to make the preacher look good. We don't have men and women today that want to see me as a one-man show. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to release the captives, to set at liberty those that are bound, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Set them free. They'll fill the house. Set them free. They'll be more than you can handle. Set them free, and they'll follow you to the gates of hell. They'll receive